Poison. Let's go. Go to bed, yo. See you in the morning, yo. Well, let's go to school. Another day of teaching school. Boarding school, yo. Let's go, I guess. Let's go down here, you know, and go to the boarding school. I mean, why not? Well, here we are at the boarding school where I teach. First class I have to teach is upstairs. Okay, let's go upstairs, I guess. Not that one. Here. I guess I'll see ya after when I'm on my break. Alright, as you can see, you know, I'm on my break. Bond. Good day. Next. Here.
Why? Because you pointed your blade at a king. Even if no one else recognizes that beautiful act of treachery, I always will. It's time for you to slay your master, Saber. You were nothing but his temporary minion. There's no need for loyalty when one is as and that's right. There is no my father felt. Father was unable to laugh or even cry. I believe that if I became king, it would put an end to that suffering.
Hey, Dora.
I thought if I just kept picking up the things father discarded, then that'd be more than enough to satisfy me. That's why I've got just one wish, and I need to fulfill it. Master, can you hear me?
I finally got through to you. What the hell's going on?
Master, I want to win.
What?
I want to win, but not to obtain the Grail. To do that, I have to defeat this poison wench no matter what.
Even if it means you die.
I don't care, Master.
All right, then let's do this.
I have just one wish, Assassin. And that's your head as a trophy!
One, another one.
There you are.
Oh, introduce yourself and tell them what you are.
Your spirit core.
My name is Amy. I am 11 years old.
You were so close.
I am a interdimensional vampire.
What the hell are you going on? So that's it?
Yep. You saw our daughter.
There still might be some hope left for you in all this. Join up with Yigga Millennia. I'm sure you can sign up.
Tell.
You were. I only got as far as I did. I was lucky enough to get teamed with you. You know, I was lying to myself all along. I wasn't actually looking for someone to be my successor. What I really wanted was to bring my daughter back.
Oh, I see. You and I both too. But I finally get it now. My father didn't seek the throne to gain comfort from sparkling jewels.
You can sit down, Emma. Thank you.
Well, that explains it then. I guess I won't be dreaming of the sword selection anymore. Because I no longer need it.
That's so. I bet you would have been a good king. What's that look? Do you want one or something?
Well, you know, I've never actually smoked one of those before.
You're completely hopeless. This is my last one.
Sorry.
Her daughter.
Hey, Master, what the hell is in this thing?
Tell me something, Saber. It was fun for you, right?
Of course it was, Master. Thanks to you.
Let's see. Give me something.
Father had fun.
Forget. Okay, so I'm on the night watch here at this school. Cool. So how about we will fuck anywhere basically, because I mean the school will be closed, no one will be around.
Done.
Cool.
As a writer,
you will not be able to defeat me, so I highly suggest that you surrender.
Quite the contrary, holy maiden, for you see, the fun begins now.
Cool.
The curtain rises. Put out thy cigarette and take thy seat. No photographs allowed. All the world's my stage, and you are merely a player. Cue the thunderous applause.
Dead when we found him, but that means she must be Master Mouth! This must be Cass. Why did you leave?
Wait, spare me, I beg you! Then perhaps thou wouldst replica of Chateau.
Impossible.
Next.
Magical energy from every ley line. As a result of this, humans will be unshackled from their bodies. Survival instincts will dissipate. Self-absorption will wane. Humanity will ascend to spiritual bodies that think. They will become immortal, without discarding emotions such as love. Humanity will likely
This? Why did I wish for him to be by my side?
I'm here to help you now.
I thought I told you. Stay away from.
If we do not have salvation,
the Lord pardons all who seek it.
I shall fulfill my duty.
So you know, there is something I neglected to tell you. Thank you. I do not know if I would have awakened, came and saved me. So please, Sieg, stay by my side until the end.
Of course. That's exactly why I came here.
I appreciate it. That alone is more than enough. God's glory. The skies proclaim his handiwork. Speech is poured forth during the day, and knowledge during the night. A fire has ignited within my heart, and continuously burns to remind me.
Could the sword she's holding be... Go, now!
You shall not interrupt her! I will protect Jean until she finishes her prayer!
He should not be capable of this at all. I was certain he was not supposed to have any powers.
This is where I meet my end. My destiny's now run its course. My life's dream has reached its conclusion. Utilizing the last thing I have at my disposal, I fight to protect the path he must walk. Lord, accept my sacrifice!
For me, this is enough.
A second noble phantasm?
Next.
Honestly, it's so heartbreaking.
We can't allow something like that to happen! What the heck are we supposed to do about it?
As long as the Greater Grail is allowed to exist in this world, Shiro Amakusa's wish will continue to affect humanity.
Master, what in the world happened to your hand?
Without command spells, you can no longer suppress it.
So then, will I become a failed version of a dragonkin?
Yes.
Hang on, the Greater Grail can fix this, right?
Yes, it is indeed possible.
Oh man, that's a real big relief. I'm really glad you still have a chance to live a proper life.
Yeah, but I would be the only normal one in a world of immortals.
Master?
I've one question, Greater Grail. With your magical energy, can you?
Indeed, I can.
Wait, what are you even saying right now?
There's really no way for us to stop the Greater Grail at this point. But this way, we can actually do something.
Stop it! That's not what I'm asking about! If you go through with it, then you'll...
not gonna die.
For someone like you, it's going to be worse than death. No one should ever ask for that kind of pain. I didn't save your life so that you'd have to face this kind of destiny. Look, I just wanted you to be happy in the end.
My time here was short, and I still saw lots of things despite that. Humans are kind of complicated, but there's one thing that I'm definitely positive of. Both you and Ruler You believe in humanity, don't you? Listen, the world can be a cruel place. Humans struggle just to survive. I don't want their efforts to go to waste. And that's why I really want this wish to be granted.
But why do you have to do it alone? Master, can't I help grant your wish?
There are still things here that can't be done by anyone but you, though. So I want you to be more involved in this world. Help someone in need, or bring joy into someone's life. You know, things like that.
Guess there's no choice then. If it's an order from my master, then I guess I have to obey.
I'm counting on you, Ryder.
You got it! I mean, I am your servant, right? Leave everything to me! Master, do your best.
I will. Same goes for you. All right. Please grant my wish.
Is this truly what you desire?
Yeah. This is what I want more than anything. Because I can feel proud knowing I did something. It's collapsing sooner than I thought! Faster, Ryder!
I'm doing my best! It's not easy while Hippo's this injured!
Watch out for any
Whoa, bad time to wake up!
Can you tell me what's going on here?
Sorry, but there's no time to explain!
Everything from the heroic spirits to humans and mages, even down to the homunculi, we are all made of the same stuff. In other words, it must be the case that we are all such stuff as dreams are made of. I cannot stop writing. I cannot stop even as the final moments draw closer.
We're out! We actually did it!
Hey! Laetitia, look! Up ahead!
I see! It is all so clear to me now! Man is but a creature that constantly aims for the open skies. However, it seems that even for a mere imitation of man, it is still possible to achieve that fantasy. I have finished it! Our heroes met in a spectacular conclusion. This tale is my latest and greatest piece of work.
Well.
Dragon? It's really Mr. C? Yup. My master actually managed to pull it off. If the Greater Grail is going to grant people immortality, then I want to take it somewhere it's not needed. That was the exact wish my master finally decided on.
Where it's not needed? You mean the reverse side of the world?
That's right. Immortality is being taken to a place where human hands will never reach it. A task like that could only be done by the phantasmal dragon Fafnir. You really are headed there, Master. Amazing. Do you think those two will ever be able to meet again? I'm sure it'll happen someday. I mean, it's gotta. Because after all, that's what the two of them wished for.
Now then, how does it feel to be on the losing side of the war, Kallus Forvege?
Honestly, it kind of sucks.
Regardless, we feel slightly indebted to you, which is why we can have a civil conversation. Otherwise, it would be an issue.
Well, that's a relief, I guess.
From the masters on your side, only three survived. Is that correct, Kallus?
It was two.
What about the third? I could have sworn it was Fiore Forvege.
My sister's not a mage anymore. She chose to give that life up before the war ended.
Although your lineage has declined, I'm certain that someone of your clan would have been accepted here with little to no problem. Well, as long as they are not the head of Yiga de Malenia.
So what you're saying is I'm banished.
It seems that destiny has determined all problematic children fall under my care for some unknown reason. As annoying as that is.
Okay, so...
I welcome you to Norwich. I'm sure the magecraft we teach you will be vastly different from the kind you were originally taught. But you should learn much from it.
You mean...
You made it! Way to go, Kallus! You're incredibly lucky, you know that? Because you, sir, are in the presence of the Clock Tower's number one instructor! And now you have the ultimate honor of learning from the great big Ben Mundanstar himself!
I told you to refrain from calling me by that asinine name, little brat.
I'm starting to have second thoughts.
Oh, hey, are you interested in primordial batteries by any chance?
Batteries?
This could have been a nightmare for the Mages Association. To think, a mere servant was able to attain some magic. Shiro Amakusa. He spent 60 years as a servant, aiming to change the world with the magic he had obtained. How absurd. It seems heroes truly are the type to do the most unexpected things, aren't they? Just like you did.
Hey! Leticia! Mr. Astolfo! I heard that you're heading out already.
Yes, you've been such a great help. Thank you for everything you've done.
Well, we kind of caused you a lot of trouble in the end, so there's really no need for thanks.
Not at all. Throughout this journey, I was able to experience things that I'm sure no other human has ever seen before. I mean, even though all I really did was just watch.
You deserve way more credit than that. I think you were super awesome!
Sorry, I'm afraid you're a bit mistaken. That was...
Thank you! There are things that wouldn't have happened had you not been brave enough to help.
Here's a bun and a smoke, two cup of nogs. Keep this.
I'm grateful that
you still have the water? Yeah. Good, good. Well, in the ritual thing.
What exactly do you plan on doing from here, Mr. Astolfo?
Oh, didn't I tell you? I have a request from Master to fulfill. He said he wanted me to get more involved in this world. So now I've got to try to bring some joy to the planet. I guess I should start practicing my smile.
How admirable. I'd like to become more involved too.
Oh yeah? Well, maybe we'll randomly run into each other at some point in our journeys.
Yes, we'll meet again. Someday. He was someone I'd quickly grown to admire. There was something so dazzling about him. It's clear to me now that she misunderstood that admiration. She sensed a strong emotion and began to project her feelings onto mine. Hey, did you finally realize it? The one who harbored those special feelings for him in the end wasn't me at all. I merely admired Mr. Sieg's way of life and respected how he treated others with the utmost kindness. So, I want you to go see him without worry, because your feelings for him are not wrong in the least.
Convoy. The church is animation.
And are currently fleeing toward the capital on the Aqua Line. The royal family has declared martial law and Sagrich will make general.
Now what's going on? Is this a revolution?
I want everybody out there immediately. Mario, take command on the scene.
Roger. Brandon, you're our liaison with the local cops.
Got it.
Boris, you're with the army. Also, I'd like you to oversee our unit placement.
You want me to do what?
Please.
Changing rides.
The fun has only just begun.
Any sign of it?
No, nothing yet.
Where could it have gone?
I'll boost satellite sensitivity.
Nope. No way. I doubt you're gonna find them. Sorry.
Kyla, show me the footage from just before the Eye of V entered the tunnel.
Sure.
Play it again. Put it on loop. That's it. And it would certainly explain things. It's a hybrid Eye of V that hasn't been unveiled to the public. The drivetrain sound is the high-pitched tone that you get from an inverter.
So that's the reason it vanished from our thermal scopes.
It's a brand new Eye of V. Stealth abilities have been augmented. I remember reading about this somewhere.
Well, of course you do, because it's a cutting-edge IFV. Word is, it was independently developed by a corrupt military country in top secret. It's known as the 5-0. Let's see. They stole a classified item, caused a ruckus, exploited its capabilities, then vanished into thin air under the cover of night. Either the work of a lunatic or a genius. Either way, this is gonna be tricky. Now then. Which is their true objective?
What on earth is that man doing? What's with all the weird squares and triangles?
If I recall correctly, he's referring to something sort of like,
You don't know, do you?
He and I have known each other for 20 years now, and I've never once known what goes on in his head.
That's nothing to brag about.
No, but if you give him time, he always comes up with an answer.
You sure?
I am.
Is it a diversion or a robbery? Or maybe it's a diversion to aid a robbery. There are two routes, one above and another below. Eric, do you remember
what
this place?
What the hell are you doing? That's an expensive monitor!
Morse Heavy Industries.
Yeah, I want to know what's beneath it.
It's the abandoned Alpine Metro Line. It connects to the Trans Island Railway, right?
The terminal station on the summit is now the Museum of Flight.
Alpha, head to the old Alpine Metro Line. Beta, to the Museum of Flight, ASAP.
As for you, contact the military. Have them keep an eye on the skies.
I'm on it, sir.
Railway police, train 645. Please respond. Do you read? Train 645.
You better be right about that bastard showing his ugly mug. Cause I swear if you're lying.
The railway police say a national rail freight is out of control on Loop Line 2. Do you think I should divert Alpha?
Don't bother. Let the army and police handle it. That is their job, right?
Wait, the IFV isn't on it.
Regardless, I'm sure the fool aboard that freight train will be made out to be the perpetrator after everything settles down. For now, we play the waiting game.
There. You! I can't believe it! You actually showed up! Hey! Work is much appreciated.
Did he show up?
Yeah.
Is it him?
Well, if Quinn won't be returning, then we'll know.
I've been instructed instructed to offer you an invitation of sorts.
This is the type of human that I'm allowed to destroy. He's one who deserves to die.
I completely understand. This just is...
They found us sooner than I expected, so just leave that there.
Huh? After all this trouble?
The gas.
Got it all.
We're going to switch over to Plan B.
And Quinn, what do we do about him?
Yeah.
He told you.
I'm ready.
Cool. Let's go to the fucking, you know, Oval. Let's shut down the cameras. There we are. Ready?
Yeah.
Cool. Pull your hair.
Can you get me?
Sure thing.
Thanks.
You're welcome. Well, I'll see you in the morning.